Tonight, only on 13, if you ever think that paying for utilities is like digging a hole in the ground and throwing your money in, you're not that far off. Citizens Energy Group is asking for big water and sewer rate hikes over the next decade. And I thought you might like to see where much of that money will go. To see your money at work, you have to get in a steel cage about the size of a small elevator. Then let a crane operator take it from there.
Marty, take us down.
The trip takes a few minutes, straight down.
So we're deep into the bedrock now, huh?
Yep, into the hard rock.
250 feet later, you've arrived.
Just a little bump on the landing.
This is the Deep Rock Tunnel, a billion-dollar solution to a costly environmental problem.
It's incredibly important. It's going to make our waterways swimmable and fishable again.
Indianapolis rivers and streams are dirty now because rainwater and wastewater go into the same sewers. And when it rains, the city's sewage treatment plants can't handle the volume. The combined sewer overflow, or CSO, goes straight to the rivers, dumping hundreds of millions of gallons of raw sewage each year. The idea is to build a massive tunnel system to hold the sewage until water treatment plants can handle it.
We're creating more or less a bathtub for the whole county, for the center part of the county that has a combined sewer.
That bathtub begins here, near the Southport Water Treatment Plant. The first phase of the tunnel system will run east, then north, until it connects with the Belmont plant between Harding and Kentucky on the south side, 7.5 miles in all. Eventually, it will run all the way to the state fairgrounds, with at least three more tunnels feeding into it, 25 miles in all. Back in the ground, contractors have been at work for more than a year. Everything in this tunnel, all the people and all the equipment, is meant to support this. This is the cutter head. It's more than 20 feet high, and when it gets moving, it goes 9 revolutions per minute with 39 cutter blades like this one to dig a hole through solid rock 250 feet below Indianapolis. The machine puts out 3,376 horsepower and removes 1,000 tons of rock an hour. The cutter blades break it up, and these rotating bins collect it and send it on a conveyor belt to the surface.
These are your start and stop buttons for some real basic things.
Stuart Lepofsky is the project manager.
The operator here is going to run is how this machine goes forward. He'll turn everything on, make sure he's got no alarms. He's got different screens he can go to, see different things.
Once the machinery is running at capacity, it will slowly grind away 24 hours a day in 3 shifts, Monday through Friday.
A good day is 150 feet?
No, that's an average day. A good day will probably be 200, 250 feet a day, maybe more.
When finished and sealed, the Deep Rock Tunnel System will be able to store 250 million gallons of raw sewage at a time, and then slowly release it to the treatment plants when they can process it. To pay for it, Citizens wants to raise water and sewer rates over 25% next year. More big rate hikes are likely in coming years, but environmentalists say customers have been underpaying for decades.
But they've been paying an unrealistically low rate for many years, more than 30 years, because they were satisfied with having raw sewage flow through the streams in Indianapolis.
But now it is the federal government that's not satisfied, and it's forcing new, stricter clean water standards on the city by the middle of next decade. A $1.6 billion long hole in the ground will allow Indianapolis to comply. Now, the first phase of the project is a relative bargain, about $231 million, and that should be completed by 2017. The entire system should be in place by 2025.